J'ai déjà appuyé.
Ouais.
Bon, après je vais filmer, je parle un peu, vous mettez soin ça sur moi, c'est simplement comme ça. C'est une vidéo. This is the heart of the city of Douala. You see here this monument entitled to a history as divided and as neo-colonial as possible.
Yes. So hold the camera, please. Hold it. You don't, yeah, just hold like that. Yes. As I was saying, this is Patrick Siani on this very sunny day in our economic capital, Littoral. Yes, I just came in here all the way from the other side of the Mungo, from Boya and through Kumba. Yes, I just came here to see how this side of the country is doing on this day, one day after October 1. Yes, that October 1, you know the history about reunification. Donc, mesdames, messieurs, je m'appelle Patrick Siani et mes amis de Facebook, je suis toujours content quand je peux vous garder un biscuit pendant mes voyages autour du Cameroun. Cette fois-ci, ça c'est le bureau de poste. Ah, c'est ici que, bon, c'est une entrée et sortie du Cameroun en quelque sorte, mais pas les lettres, oui, et même les communications téléphoniques. Bon, je suis là autour de ces placards. Vous voyez, ça c'est l'histoire du Cameroun là. C'est un soldat. Montrez les voix, ce soldat. Oui, voilà le soldat, mon grand. Oui, voilà, c'est un monument à la mémoire des militaires et marins français et alliés tombés pour l'honneur, hein, pour défendre quoi? Peut-être pas le Cameroun. Bon, voilà donc, ces Français, ces colons tombés pour défendre l'impérialisme. Mais en tout cas, on en a profité en quelque sorte parce que de là, d'une manière ou l'autre, l'histoire du Cameroun passant par Yobé et les autres, s'est trouvé avec une indépendance en main. Mais 51 ans après, comment on a géré cette indépendance? C'est ça la bonne question. Oui, donc Patrick Siani venant de Kumba, passant par Boya pour venir ici, c'était pour amener matière à réflexion sur notre Cameroun. Oui, I am just trying to build from a history that Douala is proud of. Because right from the days of the Germans, it's the Douala Mangabeyl who signed that treaty for Cameroon to be under any patronage. And it's through Douala that much of Cameroon's history and developments also take place. And here it is the economic capital. So as this guy is about going for his job, let me conclude by saying, I love you all. Cameroon is dangling between peace, progress and development and open conflict. Because as I said, as the Francophones keep blinking and pretending not to see the Anglophone problems in this country and making many fathers and homes look very wretched on October 1, we are risking going down the paracliff. We are risking going down the drains. And our history may even come to look someday if we don't take care, like the history of a country in West Africa called Côte d'Ivoire. That says it all. We should look at the big picture. The big picture, not the small one. That's why I, of LVP, am still out for forgiveness and looking ahead with an eye of hope in the future, like this cloud we have here. Yes, thank you very much, gentlemen. Yes, a beautiful city. You see, our economic capital looking very much like it can grow again. There has been a lot of talks about cleaning it up. Yes, you go around many points now, there's no longer that traffic jam again. So you see, even with my critical eye, sometimes I can look at some good things that happen in our country and say it is nice, yet we could still do better. So you can at least drive your car around here and have no little traffic jam like we used to have before, because some decisions by...